Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So, myself. My name is Norman Pamukas. This time I will present my paper, Finite Element Approaching to Investigate Residual Stresses of Cullet Welded Longitudinal Detachment. Okay. As we know that nowadays strain in welding process continue to be used more in the future because it's proven to productive and cost-effective way to join metal structure integrity. But despite many advantages of welding process for welding high quality with high tensile residual stress may lead to detrimental effect in fatigue level of the structure. And very high tensile residual stresses tend to be the root cause of several defects such as brittle fracture and lower fatigue strength. And then in this present simulation, as a goal to several finite element optimal parameters that qualitatively represent the data from physical experiment by Sahroni. As we know that residual stresses has many disadvantages in the fatigue life structure in the left image. Okay, and this method, first we use the two-way analysis method. The first one, we use the thermal modeling simulation. First one is this one, is geometry and welding parameter, material thermal properties, and thermal boundary condition. And then we simulate the thermal modeling to get thermal solution. And then thermal solution, we simulate two structure modeling. We add the isotropic hardening parameter and structure boundary condition. And then we have structure solution such as residual stresses and distortion and extra. And then the parameter of geometry and material, first one, and this is the specimen of the simulation. We have the main plate and the stiffener plate. And this is the mechanical property. We have 430 yield stress and 446 tensile megapascal. And then this is the chemical composition of the steel. And then the welding input parameter we use based on the physical experiment by Sahroni. The process is SMAW, and then current is 230 ampere, and the voltage is 24 volt. And then with current and voltage, we get the power input, input power with watt, and then we calculate the heat flux Q in order to the input data for the simulation. And then to simulate, we use the element type. We use the thermal solid element type and structure solid element type. And we need to cut in order to optimize the brick element. As you know, the brick element has an efficient solution. And then after that, in the turning area, we have like this weld width, and the other area we have like this prism weld width. Based on the volume, we calculate the heat flux duration 2.4 seconds for this prism weld width and 1.04 for this type of weld width. Then we can simulate the thermal like this one. And then we can show that this is the simulate the heat flux in the particular surface area. And then we have the temperature history from several not representative. And then we have the first one is in here and the other one is here. And all of the node has his temperature history above the steel melting temperature. Okay. And then after that, we have the thermal solution. And we have thermal solution, we need to change to solid element type, this one. Then we get this support in this particular set. And then after that, we need to calculate. We need to determine with which one of the mesh sensitivity has an optimal element size. First one, we have the millimeter element size, seven millimeter element size, and 6 millimeter element size. After all of the calculation, we determine that the 6 millimeter element size has the optimal element size based on the point reference 2 millimeter from well 2 based on the physical experimental by Sahroni. And then after that, we need to determine based on the power efficiency of the process, welding process. This we use the SMAW welding process or MMA. We know that it's around the 70, but to make sure we calculate the power efficiency, which one is has the best fit curve to the scatter data from experiment data, and we get the optimal at 70% efficiency power, 70% power efficiency. And then we need to use hardening effect. In the simulation, we use isotropic hardening, and then we simulate it, and the curve is based on the stress-strain relationship at various temperature, based on this data from Portman, Davis, Filipenko, and Sahroni. And then after simulation, we have that without isotropic hardening, almost there is no residual stresses. And with the bilinear isotropic, we slightly below the from the representative of the scatter data. And the best fitness curve is with the multilinear isotropic hardening as shown in this figure. And then we need to determine which one of the convection film coefficient has the best fitness curve. We simulate as we know that in gas in free convection we have 5 to 37, and then we use 5 convection film coefficient, 5, 15, and 25. And then we have that the 15 convection film coefficient has the best fitness curve with the scatter data. And then the next conclusion, the optimal conclusion from this simulation that has the global element size is 6 millimeter. It flux derived from 70% power input efficiency, and convection film coefficient is 15 watt per meter square Kelvin, and the hardening effect parameter with multilinear isotropic condition. This is the optimal simulation. Compared to the experimental data by Sahroni is represented with scatter data. And the further area with a bare GN ID, it has intersection on the 30 millimeter to in the 30 or to 35. Yeah, this has an intersection. Okay, thank you very much. This is the conclusion for this paper. Thank you very much for listening and watching this presentation.